Good afternoon. This media statement is updating on rabies outbreak situation in Sarawak. The state government placed the rabies outbreak under the State Disaster Management Committee. This reflects that the government takes this issue very seriously and put it as a disaster so that the government resources will be mobilized in a coordinated way between all relevant agencies. The first rabies positive human case report reported was on 30th of June 2017. The first rabies positive cases in animal was in 4th July 2017. The State Disaster Management Committee immediately on the 4th of July had its first meeting. Operation room was activated at Wismar Bapak Malaysia centralized operation room, manned by the State Disaster Management Committee, comprises of Department of Veterinary Services, Rapid Action Team, Surveillance Vaccination, Animal Rabies Laboratory Testing, and at the State Sarawak State Health Department, Crisis Preparedness and Response Center, Dog Bite Clinic. In areas affected by rabies, the resident and district officers are all on the ground. On the 27th August 2018, a total of 75,544 animals has been vaccinated. Of that, 69,337 animals had their first dose of rabies vaccine, and 6,217 re-vaccinated in the whole state of Sarawak. And the process of re-vaccination is going to continue as this animal need booster vaccine after 1 year of first vaccine. This figure excludes those vaccinated by private veterinarian. Throughout the state, anti-rabies vaccination of dogs has been ongoing almost every day, and mass vaccination on weekend in areas with high dog population. A total of 146 mass vaccination were carried out throughout the state up to this date, and there is no let up, as alleged by Yang Mohamad Chong. Even Yang Mohamad Datuk Petinggi Chief Minister attended our mass vaccination program. The Department of Veterinary Services is currently doing the second round of booster vaccination in the 650-kilometer Indian Belt bordering Kalimantan, Indonesia, to protect our local community dog. Similarly, booster immune vaccination are carried out in the buffer zone of Cebu Division to prevent spread to the other part of Sarawak. Veterinary surveillance are being conducted at all major entry points. As rabies is indeed included in our national animal disease control and eradication program, the Department of Veterinary Services Putrajaya is assisting the state by providing us with veterinary officers for civilian supply of vaccine, conducting of rabies testing at the Veterinary Research Institute, and training for the setup of our rabies testing facilities in Sarawak. As of 7th of August 2018, all tests of rabies are conducted in our own state veterinary diagnostic laboratory. This has facilitated our deployment of rapid action team to our correct areas. There was a gap in supply of rabies vaccine and personnel from Federal Department of Veterinary Services. We were informed by the Director General of DBS Malaysia on the 7th of June 2018 that there was no fund for sending their personnel to Sarawak, and requested DBS Sarawak to purchase vaccine using state fund. Subsequently, we requested fund from Yang Mohamad Datuk Petinggi Chief Minister, who immediately approved the fund. That has enabled us to continue providing free anti-rabies vaccine. The support service from Federal DBS only resumed on the 15th of August. For effective rabies control, engagement with the public and pet owner are crucial. Responsible pet owners, including vaccination and neutering of their pet, would drastically reduce the number of dogs and cats that could end up being abandoned and becoming stray. Other equally important activities that are ongoing include awareness campaign through social media, printed media, radio station, official webpage, and various campaigns throughout the state. We need public support in our effort to eradicate rabies. The state views this rabies outbreak very seriously. We spare no effort to control and eliminate this disease in the shortest possible time. So far, the state government has spent more than RM20 million in direct costs to combat these diseases. We welcome sincere and constructive suggestions and views from any group, expert and individual in our effort to control this disease. Thank you.